The gradient happens to provide very useful information about the geometry of the function. And in particular, it allows to find directions of descent, which will be very useful in the context of calculating a minimum. And the main theoretical argument is actually provided by Taylor's theorem. So what we will do in this video is to identify some of the properties related to the descent directions and provide some intuition about where they are coming from. We define a descent direction as a direction such that the directional derivative of x along d is strictly negative. And there is a theorem that says that if you follow d with a step alpha which is not bigger than eta 1, so eta 1 is a strictly positive number, then you will achieve a reduction of the value of the function. Let's take an example. Let's consider this function f of x, which is plotted on this graph. Let's consider a point x and a direction d, and we'll go to the right. So d basically here would be equal to 1. And we're interested in finding what is the value of f of x plus alpha d. So if you calculate the derivative at x, you get the tangent here, so you get a negative value. The slope is negative. So it means that if you follow this direction, d, going to the positive, the value of the objective function will decrease. And this can be seen by drawing an horizontal line. Indeed, if you draw an horizontal line, everything which is better than f of x in terms of the objective function will be below that line. And if we zoom in a little bit, we see that as soon as we leave x going to the right, we achieve values of the function that are lower than the value of f of x. But of course, you cannot go too far. So if you continue to follow this direction, at some point you will reach values of x that correspond to values of f that are higher than the point where you have started. So this property is a local property. It means that this will be true only if you perform steps that are small enough. The second result of this theorem is a little bit stronger. So not only tells you that if you follow the direction d, you will decrease the value of the objective function, but it tells you what you can expect in terms of decrease. Actually, what you can expect in terms of decrease will depend on the slope of the function at x. So this is the directional derivative. What this result says is that the value of the function that you will obtain if you follow direction d with a step alpha will be strictly less than f of x plus something which is proportional to alpha, which is the length of the step, something which is proportional to this parameter beta, which is strictly less than 1, and something which is proportional to the directional derivative, which happens to be negative. So here we have a negative number that predicts the decrease of the objective function that we can achieve by following direction d with a step alpha. Let's look at what it is on a graph. We consider the same function, and we look at the tangent. Its slope is the directional derivative. We have also plotted the line with slope beta times the directional derivative, where beta equals 0.1. And the theorem says that the new value of the function is below that line if the step is small enough. In this example, we can see that all the steps up to here will generate a value of the function which is below the line defined by beta times the directional derivative. It is a stronger result than the previous one that was based on the horizontal line. If we zoom, we can see that it is actually true on this example. As soon as you leave x toward this direction, you are below the line. And as we discussed for the case where the line was horizontal, this is valid only for small steps. If you do steps which are really too long, if you go all the way towards this part of the graph, you will achieve values of the objective function which are above the line. So this result is not valid anymore. Okay, so the result is valid locally, and this is basically a corollary of Taylor's theorem. Now the value of beta plays a role in terms of what we can predict in terms of decrease. Now if we change the value of beta, if we take a bigger value, in this example beta equals 0.7, the slope of the line that that defines the decrease changes. But again, if we zoom, we see that it is valid. So as soon as we leave the value of x, the value of the function is below that line. And actually, this would be true for any value of beta, which is strictly less than 1. Now, among all the descent directions, so among all the directions that achieve a decrease of the objective function, if we follow them, one of them is particularly interesting. It's actually provided by the gradient itself. If you take the direction d to be equal to minus the gradient, if the gradient is not 0, then this direction d happens to be a descent direction. Well, it's easy to show. So to do so, we need to write the inner product between the direction and the gradient. So this is the directional derivative of f along d at x. But now d is defined by minus the gradient. So this would be minus the gradient of f transpose the gradient of f, which is nothing else than minus the norm of the gradient square. And because the norm of the gradient is not zero, this is strictly negative, and therefore d is a descent direction. The last property that I would like to see in this video is relating the gradient with the convexity. We saw that convexity is a very important geometrical property of a function, but actually the gradient can tell us something about the convexity of the function. So namely, we have that f, the function f, is convex if and only if this result is true. So this result says that the graph of the function f of y here is never below the tangent, the hyperplane tangent. So on the right-hand side, you have the equation of the hyperplane, which is tangent to the function at x. Let's look at it from a geometrical point of view. This is the function f. If we calculate a tangent, this is a tangent, it's always below the function. So the function is above the tangent. And if we do this in many places, we always have the same result. So this characterizes a convex function. Each time you calculate a tangent, the function is above the tangent. We have seen that the gradient can be very useful. It allows to analyze if the function is increasing or decreasing along a given direction. It allows to measure how much decrease we can achieve along a descent direction. It also provides a direction, a descent direction. Minus the gradient happens to be the steepest descent direction. And finally, it also gives us some information about the convexity of the function. So this is a central tool that we will use a lot in the context of optimization.